This week on the Internet Cafe, finding a job online. This is the Monster Board, the biggest job listing site on the web. Kate Farnity runs a site called Dream Jobs. She says, why not aim for the sky and find that perfect place to work? This is software called Resume Maker, but it links to a website where you can post your resume on hundreds of job sites. Kathleen McMahon says networking on the net is the best way to find a job. She runs an online community for professional women called Bridges Online. And this is the site of ListFoundation.org, the successor to the infamous Craigslist, and a great source of job listings in new media. Finding a job on the net, this week at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z Auction, the live online shopping experience. Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support, and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise, and internet computing news, reviews, features, and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows. Additional funding from SoftSource Incorporated, publishers of Pro One's Mathematics Tutor in a Box for school year 98-99, including 6 CDs and workbook.
So we're talking about jobs online and finding jobs online and hiring people online. I'm going to tell you a little secret, or people watching a little secret. Virtually everybody we hire in our business of producing TV shows, we hire online right now.
Except me. You met me in a coffee shop.
Well, you're an exception. Everybody knows you're different, Andrew.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
But seriously, I mean, we find a terrifically efficient way to find people. I guess maybe in the media technology world, it works a bit better, but I think it's great. I mean, it just speeds up things really efficiently.
Do you use one of those resume sorting softwares that looks for keywords and, you know, if you don't have it,
no,
it
it's just there are some job banks, and we know people who are looking for this kind of stuff are going to post their resumes there, and you find cool people, and it's very fast, it's very quick, and they're always there. You don't have to, like, wait for what's coming in the mail or who's going to call you.
Right. You know, I got out of college 7-8 years ago. There wasn't all of this stuff on the web now, and I wish that there was, because it is nice.
You got a better job
than
ever.
Well, yeah, exactly. Right. No, but I mean, it was hard. It was tough. You had to go out and really still kind of, you know,
mail out old-fashioned
stuff. Rejection, and it wasn't very targeted. You know?
You get rejected online.
Right, exactly.
It's much less painful.
You just click the delete button.
Yeah, right. Jane, you do this stuff?
I've actually applied for jobs that were posted electronically.
Really?
And I've got a few of them. I've also posted my resume on the web. Haven't had a lot of success with that, but
really?
Maybe
gotta redo your resume.
Different fonts.
We got
and more
a guy
graphics.
Called Resume Maker is going to be with us tonight. You got to talk to him about making
a
better resume.
I could probably use some help on that.
And yeah, maybe by the time this evening is over, you'll get some clues as how to get a job. You'll get some clues on how to get a job.
I'm going to get unemployed.
Unemployed.
Yeah. Me too.
That's a website we need. All right, we'll be back in just a minute with more of finding a job on the web.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cmptv.com.
Miller, you're the CEO of MonsterBoard.com, and when I think of MonsterBoard, I think of sort of the biggest site on the web when it comes to jobs. I checked it out about 8 months ago when I was doing a little job searching myself. What does a mega job site have that maybe a smaller job site wouldn't?
Well, you know, if you look at it, we're the leading, most successful job site in our space, and
how do you define that most successful?
We measure our success on a couple of different fronts. One is the fact, obviously, traffic. We have 2.2 million visits a month coming to the Monster Board from the job seeker perspective, and those are all audited iPro numbers, so we're the only
2 million people a month.
It's huge.
So you have enough jobs for all those people?
Yes, we do. We have currently over 26,000 jobs, and they're fresh, available positions that are up for about 6 weeks maximum, and the employers take the jobs down when they're filled.
And so who comes to you to post these kind of jobs?
Companies, we have 4,000 companies using the Monster Board today.
Would you say larger companies, smaller companies?
We run the gamut, from Fortune 500s to the small mom and pop shops.
Really? Okay, now this is a national service. Obviously anybody anywhere on the web could get on and check this out. So how do you, you know, cater to people in the local area? What if I live here in the Bay Area? You know, how am I going to find jobs just for that?
Well, our search criteria works. There are basically three ways you can search for a job on the Monster Board. The first is by profession or job category. The second is by location. So if someone is looking for a job in a particular area, that's one of their criteria.
So you can really drill down. Because I went on, I looked, I've worked in the marketing field, and I looked in there and was able to find some some pretty good local things. Yeah. Where do you see something like this going? Any more specialization going to happen or anything like that?
Yeah, we cover the broad category of positions, unlike a lot of niche sites, either by specialty or by market. Mm-hmm. So we're not catering to any one market, but to all job seekers globally.
Now, I did see you had special channels on there, though, that look like they're geared towards different professions. I saw healthcare and things like that. So what are those about?
Yeah, we have three channels, and we believe that the internet's all about community, where people of similar backgrounds and lifestyles can congregate on the Monster Board. So we have entry level. We have HR for the HR community and hiring managers.
Oh, okay.
And then we have healthcare.
So now you say community. So is there more than just finding job postings on there? Is there a way to interact and talk with other people that are maybe looking for jobs or seeking jobs?
Sure. Through our channels, that's one of the advantages. People can ask questions and get answers from similar job seekers or employers in that particular community. So that's one of the
another
ways
area. Now, one other thing I saw that interests me, I have a little bit of an entrepreneurial family and an entrepreneurial drive, and I saw you have some things up there for people who want to, I guess, just be your own boss, or what's that thing called there?
Right. We have Be the Boss, which is another,
Be the Boss.
It's our self-employment channel on the Monster Board, and it's geared toward franchise companies looking for new franchisees.
Okay.
Or job seekers who are looking for business opportunities, not necessarily company employment.
So if I'm ready to take my job and shove it, then this is the place to go look
it's
for
also
that
the place
stuff.
To go.
Right. Now, how are you guys going to keep expanding this, keep getting it bigger? It seems like it's huge already. What's the future hold?
So, you know, it's all about traffic. Our traffic has doubled in the last 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
We're currently working with 35 other websites for traffic alliances, so that's one of our key strengths, I believe, and successes. The job postings just keep rolling in.
Right.
Companies are doing more and more online recruiting today.
So people are finding, companies are finding you a good resource for that. Well, great. Well, for my next job search, I'm going to check it out.
Super. That's www.monster.com is the place to be.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cmptv.com.
All right, Matt, you guys have a traditional piece of software called Resume Maker, but now you're upgrading it because it's got you're sort of webizing it. What are you doing actually to it?
Well, we've taken Resume Maker, which is traditional in creating resumes, and now we're giving you the ability to post it to all of the major websites online and search for jobs online.
All right, now how do I do that? First of all, I make my resume, I suppose.
Right.
And then what do I do to get it out online?
Well, Resume Maker takes you step by step through this wizard, and it allows you to select the banks you want to post to, and basically just does all the work for you and puts it into all those banks.
All right, so banks is job banks, right? And you show me a list of possible job banks I could post this to?
Right.
So I don't have to know what they are?
Yes, Resume Maker's determined the top 25 banks for you and basically transfers your resume into all of those locations.
Okay, so I can basically say click, send it to everybody?
Right.
All right, now when I send it out there, how do I know it's going to be readable? There's this nightmare of word processing formats and enclosures and attachments. How do I know it's going to work on these job banks?
Well, Resume Maker automatically transfers it into the right format for each of the banks.
Huh.
So it'll take your resume, convert it into the proper format, and just send it out there for you.
Now, suppose I don't want my current boss to know I'm out there looking for another job, and I'm worried he's out there and he's going to see my name in some resume. Is there a way to do this anonymously?
Well, you can set a security feature where you can send your resume confidential so that only your email is available, email information is available, or there's different ways they can contact you.
Can I do it through you and use you as a middleman in a way?
In some of the banks, you can actually use the career websites as the place to, they handle all the security for you.
All right, so that's a feature I think you call what, Resume Caster,
which
is really webcasting out there all my resumes.
Exactly.
Let's turn it around. I want to go look for job postings now. You've got something called Job Finder, and how does that work?
Right, Job Finder, what it does is it searches through all the major job posting sites on the internet and pulls back all of the jobs that match your criteria. So you would search on, we found jobs on Dog Catcher in Alabama, so it really, you can search on anything.
All right, so this is not necessarily doing my resume, but I just answer some questions and fill out a form and say this city, this job, this price range.
Right, this is the salary you want, this is the place you'd like to work, and it basically goes out and searches through the whole database on the internet and finds jobs that match the criteria.
And how long would that take? Suppose I went on now and said I'm looking for a job, blah, blah, blah.
It literally happens in seconds.
It
returns all the jobs that match your criteria. You can click on them and automatically send your resume to those particular jobs. It all
how big is this right now, Matt? I mean, how many potential jobs are posted on the web today?
Well, there are millions of jobs posted on the internet, literally millions. 20% of all companies are in the U.S. are doing some sort of recruiting or internet recruiting for their employees.
So what's your advice? If somebody's looking for a job, I mean, is it a waste of time typing up that letter and putting it in the envelope and putting a stamp on it?
Well, it's not a waste of time. We would still recommend you use all of the tools available to find a job, but this is really a
pretty
tool.
Pretty darn efficient, isn't it?
Yeah, you can't really not use this tool.
One other thing I really like in your software, suppose you get a contact and the guy says, yeah, come on in for an interview, you actually have these sort of practice virtual interviews there, don't you?
Right, it's called the virtual interview, and it'll take you through the top 500 questions you could be asked in an interview. So it helps build your confidence. It helps, just really helps you prepare for the interview. You'll be able to see the question, the answer, and even the reason behind why the employers ask those questions.
So how does it work? I'm sitting there, and there's some person on the computer asks me a question, and I answer them.
It's a video, and she'll ask the question. You can either type in your own answer, or you could listen to a pre-recorded answer.
Do I get rated on how well I did in that interview?
Well, it's going to give you the reasoning behind why you want to, how you want to answer it. So it's going to help you answer the question better.
All right, resumemaker.com is the URL to find out more info.
That's right.
Thanks a lot, Matt.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cmptv.com.
Kathleen, you're the co-founder of Bridges Online. That's an online women's site to help them find jobs and build community. Now, it's focused in the San Francisco Bay Area. Can you tell me a little bit about why you got started with the site?
Yeah, we're actually involved in a lot of women's organizations locally, and they were so successful at helping women connect with each other and grow their careers and find jobs that we thought, wouldn't it be great to kind of put a component of that online, where people can find each other at their own convenience within certain networking boards. So that's why we form Bridges.
So now typically when I think about going online, I think about posting my resume or doing a search on a job search area. What's different about Bridges?
Yeah, well actually in the face-to-face world, most of the research shows that the actual job is found through networking. You may look for jobs in other ways, but the way you actually find it is through networking. So that's what Bridges is about. Can we help people network to find the jobs rather than just list a bunch of jobs?
So how do you do that?
Well, we provide these networking boards, and they're broken up by industry. So there's like a tech writer's one, there's an administrative one, and there's a lawyer's one. And so if you're a lawyer, you could go into the lawyer board and find where other lawyers are posting, as well as employers who are looking for legal type of positions.
So that leads me to another question. I mean, do you find most of the people that go to the site are mostly technical people, women in technology?
They actually tend not to be. They tend to be more the non-technical. We do have both, and we have an internet board. But most of the people are non-technical, using technology to find a job, but not technical.
So now when I, at your site, you also have a link in at AOL as well. So
yes.
You do have moderated chat, so you can talk about specific topics.
Yes, and this helps our community. We actually do a happy hour from 7 to 8 every night, and people come in after work, and they either vent about how horrible their day was or how great it was. And we also do special topics like sexual harassment and breaking through the glass ceiling, and we have an hour Ask the Recruiter where women can come and talk to an agency person and ask them questions.
So now do you find that you get as much participation from the potential employers as much as you do the people looking
for
jobs?
We really do, because there are fewer and fewer resources online where employers can post jobs for free. And they know that they've got a good qualified audience. They also have part of the AOL audience, so they can come in and find candidates that are real qualified, real fast. So we do have great participation by the local companies.
Any examples of some successes you've had as
a
result?
Yeah, actually we have one employer who just last week, she posted and she was looking for a pool of transcription people. Didn't want to go to an agency, didn't know where to go. So she just kind of put her idea out there in the temporary message board. And 8 people applied immediately, and she tried several of them and said, I can't even choose because they're all great. So she actually made a phone call to me and said, I can't believe this thing is free because it's so effective. So it made us feel really nice.
That's great. So it was a win-win on both sides,
really. On both sides, because they were having problems finding jobs, too. So it really brought them together in a nice way.
Now, Bridges Online is really focused in the Bay Area, San Francisco area. Are you planning to expand?
We are. It's a great analogy for the Bay Area to have bridges to careers and so forth. But we are going to expand it into other regions. And it's really nice to have a regional focus so people feel like you know their job market. So we will be growing that piece by piece.
That's great. What's next? Which city?
L.A.
There you go. Stay in California.
Yes.
We're going to bridge out later.
There you go.
Thanks a lot, Kathleen.
You're welcome.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cmptv.com.
Well, it's one thing to find a job on the web. It's another thing to find the perfect job or a dream job. And I guess that's the lucky job you have, Kate, is helping people find dream jobs at the Hotwired site. Let's talk in general about this idea of finding a job on the web. This is really happening now, isn't it?
It is. It is more and more. And you're seeing more and more companies and recruiters getting online all the time.
Now, let's go back to the dream job concept. I mean, this is obviously raises the bar a little bit, as I suggested. What is a dream job? What is on your site that you might not find on another sort of routine job site?
Well, the idea behind a dream job is a job that makes you smarter. And the goal is to get people to start thinking in new ways about the role that work plays in their lives.
Well, what does that mean, make you smarter? I mean, is this going to school or is this having a job?
No, it's about a job actually contributing to your development as a person. It's a job where you can learn. It's a job where you can sort of expand. You can, move up.
So you're saying part of what goes on in this dream job site is not necessarily just finding a job, but figuring out for yourself what a dream job means.
It's true. I think more and more people are interested in finding jobs that suit them in particular ways or that will
make you feel good about what you do. Like, it's not just money anymore.
Yeah, right? It's true.
All right, let's talk about some of the jobs that are on your site. You don't have that many jobs there. You focus on more quality than quantity, isn't it? What are the kinds of jobs that you have on your site?
Well, our main focus at Wired and at Hotwired is technology.
Yeah.
So we really focus on high-tech and new media jobs. So there's always a technology element, but I'm trying to get a pretty broad range of jobs.
But given that, in that whole range, there's a million jobs there, what is the dream job? What are the kinds of jobs you would choose to list?
Well, we focus on all different kinds of jobs, everything from the high-profile sort of entertainment industry, some of the things that people are really excited about right now, like animation, but two more down-to-earth public service, things like wiring schools, bringing computer and technology.
So people
want
to feel they're doing
public.
Something useful, they're contributing, not just getting paid, et cetera.
Yeah, exactly.
But they want different things these days, right? You want to be able to come in late, and you
it's
don't
true.
Have to get dressed up.
It's true. And my dream job and your dream job are obviously not going to be the same. So the idea is really to get people thinking about what is really important to them and look at, there is a scope of jobs out there that'll...
Now, what I find interesting on your site is you actually go in there and look at other people's postings, and it's kind of fun to see how other people present themselves and how they're showing, why somebody ought to hire them. Is that intentional to really get to see how the process works?
That it is, and I mean, a lot of what Dream Jobs is about is looking sort of behind the front door, getting deeper into a work environment and seeing who the people really are and what a day in the life is really like.
And you actually have discussion threads on there, too, which people talk about the process. What goes on there?
People post their resumes, they post other job listings, they talk about their frustrations and
whether the job really was a dream
job. It's true, yeah.
Now, you've got this grass is greener section, what's that?
We have a section called the greener grass.
Greener grass.
Yeah, which is about, it's sort of like an archive of past dream jobs. These are the companies that we really, really like.
Now, do you have a consensus based on what you've been doing so far? You post these dream jobs, people apply for them. What people are looking for, I mean, what these days, especially in the tech field, people think of as a dream job?
People are looking for more flexibility. They're looking for a lot more creative input, even in the real serious sort of programming coding jobs. People are looking for creativity and flexibility more and more.
Money is not that important?
Money is important, but it depends. People are willing to make concessions. There's all different levels.
As long as they get stock options.
Stock options, yeah.
That's more important than salary now.
Or a lot of sense of satisfaction that they're really helping people.
And are you helping people? Are people finding jobs on the site?
Yeah, they are. I think just about every job ends up getting filled.
All right, dream job with Hotwired.
Yeah.
Thank you, Kate.
You're welcome. Thank you.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cmptv.com.
Craig and Nancy, you're here from a bona fide San Francisco phenomenon, I think, with first Craigslist and now the List Foundation, and in the new media circles, this is sort of, I've heard the buzz a long time about Craigslist, and I'd like to hear from you really what it is and how did it start?
Well, how it started was basically a simple distribution list for a few friends who I wanted to tell about events.
Via email.
Via email. That might be useful, might be fun, might be both.
Mm-hmm.
It started growing word of mouth, and then people started asking me if I could put jobs there, stuff for sale.
Okay.
And it just wound up growing in a way out of control.
And how big is it now?
Recently, in the past few days, it passed 7,500 subscribers. A lot of people, of course, prefer just to go to the website.
So you have your choice. You can subscribe to the email list, or you can go to the website.
And some people do both.
Okay.
It adapts to the way people want to use it.
Okay, so you have your choice of either. Now, what kind of information are you offering? You said jobs, you said stuff, places to live, and things for sale. What kind of target audience is this? Anybody or?
It's pretty much anybody. Mm-hmm. Of course, it has to be someone who has email or web access.
So fairly web savvy person.
Pretty much so, mm-hmm. although...
Everybody has email now, right?
In the city, there's a lot of people who are just starting, found out about it right away, and subscribed.
Okay, and I'm going to guess that the fact that we're sort of in a multimedia city here in San Francisco, most of the jobs are more of a tech focus. Would you say that's true?
Right now, certainly a lot of them are, although the percentage is dropping as more and more people find out about the mm-hmm. list. Mm-hmm. And post different kinds of jobs.
Right.
It feels pretty good.
Right, right. The other thing that I've heard, and maybe Nancy can talk to this a little bit, I've heard friends of mine who are really into it are looking for apartments, and San Francisco is one of the toughest places to find apartments. Is there anything special that gives people an advantage of being on Craigslist for that kind of stuff?
The immediacy.
The immediacy, mm-hmm. meaning?
Meaning we get the information early on and we pass it on immediately,
in this market, things go. I mean, I remember looking for a place mm-hmm. a while ago, and there's 30 people by the time you show up to look at an apartment. So.
Absolutely. It goes very quickly, and I think that by far and away is the service that we offer.
Okay. Now, speaking of service, I understand that Craigslist has now gone to a foundation, actually the List Foundation,
mm-hmm.
and that sounds like a nonprofit to me. Is that
it
correct?
It's a bona fide nonprofit.
Okay, so what is the mission? What are you guys going to accomplish with that?
Our goal is to help people transition their careers, and in so doing, we're providing jobs training, mentoring, and coaching programs.
So people can actually submit to, I want to change my career, I'm looking to get into this industry. And you found things for them? Is that the way it works?
Or? Yeah, we're working on our first experiment right now. An individual who was out of the job market for a period of time and wanted to move into new media, and in so doing had to learn how to become wired.
Okay.
So we're taking from ground zero to competent wired. And I think the technologists, in particular Craig, being able to say, I was trained in this community is going to give just about everybody a competitive advantage.
Give them sort of the edge.
Yeah.
So this sounds like something new. This is a future project. So it sounds like you've taken Craigslist, the original phenomenon, now you're making it something larger.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds like there's a chance people even from outside of San Francisco could come here and find a mentorship.
Yes, as a matter of fact, our jobs are not just in San Francisco, and the mentoring won't be just in San Francisco. We recently posted, I think, our most distant job, which was from South Africa, and our most interesting job, which came out of Lucasfilms.
Really? Lucasfilms. Well, we're going to have to check it out online.
Yeah, you should.
Well, we've learned a little bit about finding a job online, and I saw a couple cool things. Dream Job site, the thing that Hotwired is doing. You know a little mm-hmm. bit about the Hotwired
mm-hmm.
folks.
Yeah.
Very cool site, because not only do you find a job, but it gets you to think about what kind of job you really want.
Especially in the new media
yeah.
genre, there's just all kinds of jobs that just were not here a few years
right.
ago.
I like it because it went beyond just the job matching kind of thing. I mean, mm-hmm. that's sort of baby stuff, but it really got you to participate, kind of interactive website, which was cool.
Right.
Plus Resume Maker, I mean, baby stuff for anybody can now. You were saying before, some people don't get into this.
Right.
But now I think anybody can use a simple piece of software. Boom, you're out there on a million job listings all around the country.
Right, right. My question is, does it really work? There's a lot of sites where you can submit resumes to people, but I haven't really met anybody that's got a job yet
really?
Off that, so I'm not sure. My other concern I'm a little worried about is access for beginners, folks who are maybe just getting into the
yeah.
job market, either high school students or college graduates. I don't think these are really jobs for them yet. I think these are more, the ones I've seen are a little more advanced, a little more technical. I haven't seen a lot of entry-level stuff. I don't
know. What I found with Bridges Online was that the concept of building community, sharing experiences, meeting other people looking for similar jobs was really effective and also a great tool for employers to come and sort of get a look at the pool of potential candidates. It worked quite well. So.
But it's still kind of in its baby form, like anything else on the web. I mean, where maybe 20% of the available jobs might be posted on the net right now, but I think as this grows, certainly your concern is a good one. Yeah, you don't see entry-level jobs, little jobs on the web.
Right, I mean, and people may not have net access as
well. Well, but ironically, I think it's a fact all the kids just getting out of college that do have net access are probably looking for jobs.
Right.
So still a little bit of work to be done.
Yeah.
Anyhow, that's it for Finding Jobs Online. We'll see you here next week again at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z Auction, the live online shopping experience. Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support, and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise, and internet computing news, reviews, features, and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows. Additional funding from SoftSource Incorporated, publishers of Pro One Software, educational software for young adults. To purchase a videotape copy of today's program, call toll-free 1-888-310-7850. Please specify the show number and the topic.
Why are you leaving your current position?
When I first started with the company, it was about 10 miles away from home, which was perfect. But since then, they've expanded, and the new office is about 50 miles away, which makes for a two-hour day commute. Although I really enjoyed the job, I just didn't feel as productive as I was before the move.